In this video, I'll show you how to prepare evidence for ISO 27001 certification audit using a software like Conformio. Now, the purpose of a certification audit is for an auditor to actually check out not only your documents and records, but also to make sure that all of your employees are following your security policies and procedures, and the certification auditor wants to verify all of these things. Okay, let's see how Conformio ISO 27001 software can help you prepare this evidence for the certification audit. The most important and most useful part are these tabs, documents and clauses and evidence. In the tab documents, you actually have a list of all the documents from Conformio. You also have an indication which one is mandatory, which one is not. So you can see it here. And you also have the status, when was it last changed, which are the relevant clauses and so on. So you have in one place an overview of all the documents and their status. And you can also very easily search for a particular document or filter them out. Let's say you want to see only the ones that are in progress. You simply click apply filter and then you will see those that are in progress but are not published yet. And this documents tab is basically the most useful for stage one audit. So stage one audit is really about document review. Now for stage two audit, where the certification auditor actually wants to find out evidence for each and every clause and each and every control, this is where this second tab, clauses and evidence, is much more useful, because here you actually have a breakdown per each clause and subclause and each control of the standard. What is your level of compliance? For example, let's say that you want to see for leadership, for all three subclauses of this main clause, the company here is compliant. But if you scroll down, you will see also all the controls. So let's say for all the physical controls, this company is already either a compliant or the company has marked some of these controls as not applicable. But for example, for let's say these A.5 controls, some of these controls are not ready yet for an audit. You can also search for particular controls. So let's say that I want to see the backup control, then it will show automatically here in the list. Now let's go back to this first tab, documents. And let me just briefly explain these KPIs. So basically here you have a KPI on the total number of completed documents. And here you have the total number of completed clauses. As you can see, the company is fully compliant with all the clauses. And here you have the number of completed controls, 49 out of 57. By the way, this is 57 because 57 are, for this particular company, found applicable in the statement of applicability. This is why this is not 93 as the full number of controls. Okay, now, if you want to go into details of each and every of these items, you simply scroll down to the one that you're interested in and then click on it just to see exactly what the details. So basically it says, it tells you what is the name of the document, when was it last changed, who is the owner, a short explanation of this document, which are relevant clauses. And of course you can open directly this document or download it. So let's say if I want to open it, you will see directly the text of the document. Okay, similar thing when I go for this clauses and evidence, it gives you even more information. So let's say that I want to check out what is with 9.2 internal audit. As you can see, it's ready for certification audit. This means that the company has done all the steps. So when I open it, you will see the details. First, you will see the explanation, what this clause is about. It explains you how this is implemented and it shows you all the documents which are part of this clause, and there you can actually see that all of these three documents were approved. And when I go here, I can go directly to this step in the implementation, for example, like this. Okay, or of course I can download the document itself. Here you also have some further evidence of implementation, some certain records, and here you can also see that this is this internal audit procedure with a program report, but also the internal audit checklist that was filled out during the internal audit. You can also add your own notes. So basically you can add anything that you wanted to write manually, but you can also add links to any external or internal resources, let's say files or records on, let's say, your SharePoint or any file management system that you have. You can also, of course, upload any of these files here directly to Conformio. When I close this, let's say that I want to see a particular control. Let's go here for this A.5 and let's go for classification of controls. I can see a very similar thing for this 8.5.12. The explanation, implementation methods, what is the documents, and also what are the additional records that can be found for this particular document. Now, the question is, how does Conformio help you with automating of these documents and records? First of all, whenever a particular document is marked as approved, then it is changed here. The status here is changed into ready for an audit. For example, when this internal audit procedure was approved, or internal audit program and report, when all of these things are approved, then this whole clause becomes green and becomes ready for an audit. Also, whenever you create automatically some reports, let me show you some other clause. So clause, let's say 10.2. So when you actually create these a quarterly summary of corrective actions and non-conformities, this also automatically is recorded here under the evidence. And therefore, you have this connection between the records and the readiness for an audit. Similar thing with any tasks. If you use Conformio, then you know that you can also create various tasks, which are then mapped towards particular clauses or controls. When these tasks are marked as completed, then also this control is marked as ready for an audit. Now, if you wonder how your company needs to create all of this evidence, basically you have to follow all of your security policies and procedures. So for example, if your backup policies, it says that you have to perform the backup every 6 hours, then you need to show evidence, meaning records, that the backup is really being done every 6 hours. Now, if you want to make sure that each and every piece of evidence exists, then you actually have to go through all of your security policies and procedures, through all of your statement of applicability, and make sure that you are really performing everything that was specified there. Now, the auditors do not insist that they actually access your software through which you implemented the standard. They only want to see the evidence, and they can get to this written evidence directly in your operational systems, for example, on your backup server. Now, Conformio helps you with this by listing all the records that you actually have to create for each document. For example, here for this Bring Your Own Device policy, when you scroll down to the section 4, you will see a section which speaks about the managing records based kept on this document. And you see here, let's say, list of approved users of BYOD, so Bring Your Own Device, so who is approved, where is this records located, who is in charge, and so on. Also, list of acceptable BYOD devices and their settings, and list of prohibited BYOD applications. So all of these things are prescribed in the section 3 of the documents, together with the rules on how this is done. But section 4 summarizes all these records with the main idea actually of helping companies know exactly what kind of records they have to create as evidence that they are performing all of these activities. Now, of course, if you want, you can give these auditors an access to your ISMS software, but then you should give them the access only to documents and potentially records, but not to everything that you're doing in this software. For example, here in Conformio, in this user management module, you can invite a certification auditor as a user. So by clicking here, invite user, and then you can select the option that this is an auditor. And by this, they can access only the audit and evidence dashboard, all approved documents and uploaded evidence, but cannot make any changes and cannot see anything else what you have done in Conformio. Now, if you wonder whether these documents and records are all the evidence the certification auditor will be looking for, the answer is unfortunately no, because the auditor will be looking for three types of evidence. One is this written evidence, all these policies and procedures, records, and so on. But for some activities, there are no written records. For example, if you install CCTV cameras or certain cables or certain doors, there doesn't need to be a document around it. So this is something that the auditor will check through personal observation. So this will be an observational type of evidence. But in some cases, it is also not possible for a certification auditor to observe that something is happening. In this case, the auditor will be able to verify that some activities are happening only through an interview with your employees. So for example, if you're implementing this control segregation of duties in your software development process, where a junior developer writes a code and then a senior developer reviews this code, so basically you're segregating the development and the review part, then the only way for an auditor to find out if this is really being done is by interviewing both a junior and senior developer. So this becomes a verbal evidence. And all of these three types of evidence have an equal importance for an auditor. All of these three types of evidence are perfectly accepted as evidence that you are, that your company is compliant. So what does this mean in practice? This means first that the software cannot capture all the evidence, because this observational evidence and verbal evidence is something that needs to be captured directly by the auditor during the certification audit. And second, to make sure that these interviews performed by an auditor and these observations that are done by an auditor, if you want to make sure that these actually turn out right, then you have to train your employees and make them aware what are the security rules that they have to follow so that everything is done right. So to summarize, certification audit is going to be very detailed. And if you want to make sure that you will pass this audit, you have to make sure that all of your employees understand all the security rules, but also that they are trained to follow these rules and that they are aware of why security is important. And of course, you can use tools like Conformio for capturing all this written evidence. And in some of the plans of Conformio, we also included the security awareness and training, just to make sure that not only your written evidence is available, but that you also can present verbal and observational evidence. Hope this was helpful, and you can sign up for a free trial of Conformio by clicking this link in the description below, and you'll be able to test out not only this audit and evidence, but also other elements of Conformio. And if you found this video useful, please give it a thumbs up, and you can also subscribe to my YouTube channel not to miss any of my new videos, and I publish ISO 27001 videos every week. Thanks for watching!